Hey guys, it's Alex here from alextubi.com and welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're anything like me, you're probably on your computer most of the day, have anywhere from 10 to 20 tabs open in your browser, and are constantly working on multiple projects at the same time. If you can relate, then this video is for you because I'm going to share all the amazing Chrome extensions I use to help organize my processes, save time, spy on my competitors, and more. So if you haven't already, hit the subscribe button below and let's get started. So the first extension I can't live without is called OneTab, and it solves that first problem that I mentioned, which is having way too many tabs open at the same time. So OneTab actually allows you to consolidate all the tabs you have open into a singular page. It displays them in a vertical list, and I find it so much easier for me to actually utilize all the tabs I have open, or at least know what they are. And it also speeds up my computer by not having too many things running at the same time. The next Chrome extension that I use regularly is the FocusToDo Pomodoro timer. So if you haven't heard of a Pomodoro timer before, basically it encourages you to work on projects in 25-minute increments. So the idea is that if you spend 25 minutes working on one singular task, you're more likely to finish multiple tasks throughout the day than if you're just clicking around and kind of doing a few minutes here, a few minutes there. So this Chrome extension allows you to create a list of all the projects that you want to work on, and from there you can start the Pomodoro for each individual project, and when that 25 minutes is up, it'll encourage you to take a 5-minute break, or you can continue working and it'll actually track how many 25-minute increments it took for you to finish a project. So in the future, you know that when it comes to writing a blog post, it typically takes you 50 minutes. So that's super helpful for, you know, yourself and maybe your employees if you have them use this type of tool, so you can really track how long it takes to get shit done. Next is one that, since I've started using, I simply cannot live without, and that is the video speed controller. So you know how on YouTube you can choose to watch videos at 1.25 or 1.5 or whatever speed that you like? Well, this Chrome extension allows you to do that to any video on the internet. So whether it's a video from an online course or a video you're watching on Netflix, you can increase the speed to whatever speed you desire and really consume content a lot quicker. Ever since I started using this, watching something at 1x speed is really painful. So this is definitely one of my favorites. Next is keywords everywhere. Now, I've talked about this tool before in this video, but it is a game changer for conducting keyword research, which is super important for your website SEO and your content creation here on YouTube. This Chrome extension shows you exactly how many people are searching for a specific keyword or a string of words per month, which allows you to determine if that keyword is worth targeting with your content. Now, if done right, your content is going to rank in Google or on YouTube because you focused on that keyword, and you're gonna get a ton more traffic and views. So again, I do have a video that explains this tool and how to use it in detail up here and in the description box below, so go ahead and check that out. Next is DuckDuckGo, and this is an alternative to Google. So as you may or may not know, Google tracks basically every single thing that you do and retargets you with advertisements and potentially is spying on your actions and maybe even the things that you say when you use their browser. Now, I'm not gonna get too deep into the conspiracy theory, but DuckDuckGo is an alternative that allows you to search without being tracked and without your history being logged to your IP address. So even if you're not looking up anything weird on the internet, it is important to protect your privacy, and I think this is a really easy Chrome extension to add. So that's all I'm gonna say about that. I really like this tool, definitely worth it in my opinion. The next is GoFullPage, and this is an incredible tool for capturing anything on the internet that you wanna keep for inspiration or just to have on hand. So what this allows you to do is basically take a screenshot of an entire web page, no matter how long it is, and it saves it into one single PDF. So typically, if you were to take a screenshot, it's just gonna grab whatever you can see on the screen at that time. But oftentimes, pages are much longer than what you can see, and you're typically scrolling for a while to reach the bottom. So GoFullPage allows you to capture all of that in one click. So I'll typically use this if I find a design that I like and I want to use it for inspiration for maybe something that I create in the future. Of course, I'm not intending to copy anyone, but instead I just like to keep it for my own reference so that when I'm designing something, I can say, hey, you know, I really liked how this looked on her page, so I'm gonna go ahead and maybe recreate that in my own way. So by using GoFullPage, I can easily capture and keep anything that catches my attention for later use. Then we've got WhatFont. So this tool is super handy and goes hand in hand with the GoFullPage because it allows you to figure out which font someone is using on any web page on the internet. So if you're trying to design something and you saw a font that you really liked on someone's website, you can just use this Chrome extension to hover over that font and it will tell you exactly what it's called and even the size of the font as well as the weight of the font. So it's such a simple yet really handy tool and I love having it in my Chrome extensions bar. Then we have SimilarWeb. So this tool allows you to see how much traffic an individual website is getting. So what you'll see is what their total monthly viewers are and where those views are coming from. So specific social media pages, as well as individual blogs or other page referrers. So you can use this data for a variety of reasons, but I particularly use it for when someone reaches out to me and wants to work with me. So maybe they want me to be on their podcast, or maybe they want me to write a blog post for them. By looking at this SimilarWeb Chrome extension, I can see how much traffic they're getting and how much of a benefit it may be for me to work with them. So that's how I particularly use it, but you can also use it just to spy on your competitors to see how they're doing and where their traffic is coming from, because maybe you can get similar results as well. So there are a ton of Chrome extensions out there and I know hundreds that I've never tried before. So I would love for you to tell me in the comments below which Chrome extension you can't live without so that I can check it out. And as always, please hit the like, subscribe, and notification bell so that you never miss another video from me. That's it for today, guys. Thanks so much for watching and I will see you next time.